Hello dear students, as I told you that I am going to make a video, YouTube video on the wheel and axle question that was there in Set-2 of GATE 2021. And actually I planned to make a detailed video to discuss a lot of things about that question, because there are multiple places where silly mistake is possible in that question. But I was extremely busy today. I could not find time to, you know, properly explain and record that video. So I will postpone that. Maybe I will tell you these things for future GATE, what possible silly mistakes are there which you might not be knowing, because rolling is such a topic where I feel, especially the friction case, where I have explained this to you in the course in great detail, and I told you it's a point, it's a topic which is extremely important for GATE 2021. So there are many things that I want to discuss, but obviously the time constraint is there. The challenge window will close in few hours. So let me discuss that here briefly. Okay, the system, the laptop is in front of me. I have the question in front of me. I am referring to the question. Look, there's one point where students are, planning to challenge it. Two points actually. I will discuss both of them. First is that neglect the moment of inertia of the axle, this statement. Because in this statement, it's asking you to neglect the moment of inertia of the axle, but it is not telling you that moment of inertia about which axis, right? Because as we know, moment of inertia has to be defined with respect to an axis, right? So there's one thing that you should understand here, that axle is a very specific thing which has a specific type of motion, right? So you will see many sources, many standard sources also, where axle will be mentioned, moment of inertia will be written, but it will not be mentioned which moment of inertia. It automatically means, it's understood that it is talking about the polar moment of inertia of the axle, the rolling motion that it performs about its central axis in that frame of reference. That moment of inertia it is talking about. But yes, from the point of view of challenging, what we have to do, we have to find all the possible flaws in the question which might have confused us in the test, in the GATE, right? So this point, if you want to challenge it on that basis, I agree that it would have confused some of you. Those who would have tried to write the torque equation about the point of contact, they definitely would have confused, because you cannot ignore moment of inertia about the point of contact. You can do it only about its own polar axis, because R value is very less. Axle is slender, right? But you, if you want to do it about point of contact, you cannot do it. Its mass is 1.5 kg and its distance is equal to the radius of the wheel. So M and R both are significant values that cannot be ignored, that cannot be considered negligible, right? But obviously, those of you who would have tried to do that about the point of contact, this line could confuse them. So this is something which, if you challenge, it will be, if it is accepted, marks will be given to everybody, because that's a problem in the question, right? But in my view, the chances that GATE will accept this challenge of moment of inertia statement is very less, because as I told you, in many standard sources, it's almost understood that if axle is something that we are talking about, its moment of inertia we are ignoring, obviously its polar moment of inertia, right? So those of you who want to challenge it, definitely you can challenge it, but the chances that this part of moment of inertia will be accepted are quite less. Coming to the second point where students are planning to challenge it, the direction of rotation. Now this is something that I would have enjoyed explaining on the whiteboard, but I will keep it short and I will just tell you whether you should challenge that on the basis of direction, on the basis of torque equation or not. You can challenge it on that basis, on the direction of torque. That's the short answer. Those of you who have shared with me over email and in our Facebook group have shared all the complete detailed explanation and different sources, they can use those sources to challenge the range of this question or to challenge the answer of this question. I'm sure this video gave you a clarity, because time is limited. So I don't want to, you know, discuss all those things right now, but as soon as this thing is over, you are done challenging and I also get somewhat free, I will explain the detailed concept once more on the YouTube. I wish you all the best.